Okay.
Vanakkam. This is a unique program, an e-book of the Gita with the commentary of Swami Chidbhavanandaji is being launched. I would like to appreciate all those who have worked on this. Thanks to this effort, tradition and technology have merged. E-books are becoming very popular, especially among the youth. Therefore, this effort will connect more youngsters with the noble thoughts of the Gita. Friends, this e-book will also deepen the connect between the eternal Gita and the glorious Tamil culture. The vibrant Tamil diaspora spread globally will be able to read it easily. The Tamil diaspora has scaled new heights of success in many sectors, yet they are proud of their cultural roots. They carry with them the greatness of Tamil culture wherever they went. Friends, I would like to pay homage to Swami Chidbhavanandaji, mind, body, heart and soul. He was a life devoted to India's regeneration. He planned to study abroad, but destiny had different plans for him. One book he saw at a roadside bookseller, Swami Vivekananda's Madras lectures, changed the course of his life. It inspired him to put the nation above everything else and serve the people. In the Gita, Sri Krishna says, Yad yad acharti sreshtah, tat tat eva etare janah, sa yat pramanam kurute, lokah tat anuvartate. This means, whatever great men do, many are also inspired by them to follow. On one hand, Swami Chidbhavanandaji was inspired by Swami Vivekananda. On the other hand, he went on to inspire the world with his noble deeds. The Ramakrishna Tapovanam Ashram has been carrying forward the noble work of Swami Chidbhavanandaji. They are doing commendable work in community service, healthcare, and education. I would like to appreciate Sri Ramakrishna Tapovanam Ashram and wish them the best for their future endeavors. Friends, the beauty of the Gita is in its depth, diversity, and flexibility. Acharya Vinoba Bhave describe the Gita as a mother who take him in her lap if he stumbled. Greats like Mahatma Gandhi, Lokmanya Tilak, Mahakavi Subramanya Bharati were inspired by the Gita. The Gita makes us think. It inspires us to question. It encourages debate. The Gita keeps our mind open. Anybody who is inspired by the Gita will always be compassionate by nature and democratic in temperament. Friends, one would think something like the Gita would have emerged in peaceful and scenic surroundings. But as you all know, it was in the middle of the conflict that the world got the finest life lesson in the form of the Bhagavad Gita. The Gita is the greatest source of knowledge about everything that we can hope for. But have you ever thought what causes this knowledge to pour out from the words of Sri Krishna? It is vishad or sadness. The Bhagavad Gita is the treasure of thoughts that reflects the journey from vishad to vijay. When the Bhagavad Gita was born, there was conflict, there was vishad. Many feel today humanity is passing through similar conflicts and challenges. The world is fighting a tough battle against a once-in-lifetime global pandemic. The economic and social impacts are also far-reaching. In such time, the power shown in the Srimad Bhagavad Gita becomes ever relevant. It could provide strength and direction to once again emerge victorious from the challenges humanity faces. In India, we saw many instances of this. Our people powered fight against COVID-19. The outstanding spirit of the people, the courage of our citizens. One can say that behind this are glimpses of what Gita highlights. There is also a spirit of selflessness. We saw this time and again when our people went out of the way to help each other. Friends, last year there was an interesting article in the European Heart Journal. This is a peer-reviewed journal of cardiology published by the University of Oxford. Among other things, the article talked about how the Gita was most relevant in these COVID times. The Bhagavad Gita was described as an accurate guide for living a fulfilling life. The article compares Arjun to the healthcare workers and the hospitals as a battlegrounds for the war against the virus. It appreciated the healthcare workers for doing the duty, overcoming any fear and challenge. Friends, the core message of the Bhagavad Gita is action. Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, Niyatam kuru karmatvam karma jayo hakarmana. Sarir yatra pichate na prasiddhe da karmana. He is asking us to indulge in action because it is far better than inaction. In fact, he says, we cannot even take care of our body without action. Today, the 1.3 billion people of India have decided their course of action. They are going to make India Atmanirbhar or self-reliant. In the long term, only a self-reliant India is in everyone's interest. At the core of Atmanirbhar Bharat is to create wealth and values not only for ourselves but for the larger humanity. We believe that an Atmanirbhar Bharat is good for the world. In the recent past, when the world needed medicines, India did whatever it could to provide them. Our scientists worked in a quick time to come out with vaccines. And now, India is humbled that vaccines made in India are going around the world. We want to heal as well as help humanity. This is exactly what the Gita teaches us. Friends, I would specially urge my young friends to have a look at the Bhagavad Gita. The teachings are extremely practical and relatable. In the middle of past-paced lives, the Gita will provide an oasis of calm and peace. It is a practical guide for several dimensions of life. Never forget the famous verse, Karmanyeva Adhikaraste Ma Phaleshu Kadachana. It will free our mind from fear of failure and put our focus on our action. The chapter on Jnana Yoga deals with the importance of true knowledge. Bhakti Yoga, teaching us the importance of devotion, is touched upon in one of the chapters. Every chapter has something to offer to cultivate a positive frame of mind. Above all, the Gita reinforces the sentiment that each one of us is a spark of the Supreme, the all-powerful Divine. This is something even Swami Vivekananda highlights. My young friends, be having to cope with many tough decisions as well. During such times, always ask yourself, if I were in place of Arjuna, facing this dilemma, what would Sri Krishna ask me to do? This works brilliantly because you suddenly start detaching your own likes and dislikes from the situation. You start looking at it from the eternal principle of the Gita, and it will always take you to the right place and will always help you taking tough decisions. Once again, congratulations on the launch of the e-book with commentary authored by Swami Chidbhavanandaji. Thank you. Vanakkam.